Hello, Facebook friends. I'm Evangelist David Pate. Thank you so much for all the kind comments and the inbox messages of encouragement. Thank you most of all for sharing these videos, because this is an evangelistic outreach. And when you share these videos, you're helping perpetuate the gospel. And I want to encourage you to keep sharing as God would lead. I want to speak to you out of Acts chapter 4 tonight. And it's too long a story to read, so I want to just touch on a few scriptures. But it starts out with Peter and John, and they're going to the temple to praise God. And there's a lame man, and he's laying at the gate, and he's crippled. He's been crippled for 40 years, and he's begging for money. And when he looks at Peter, Peter looks at him, and he says, "Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have I give to thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk." And the Bible says the man jumped up. He received strength in his legs, and he jumped up leaping for joy, praising God. And what an awesome miracle. But the Sadducees and the priests, the religious people that were against Christ, that helped crucify Christ, they pulled him in. And was very upset with them because they had done it in the name of Jesus and people were believing on Christ. They were trying to persecute and put down Christians. They didn't want it to. They thought when they put Christ down or when he was crucified that that was the end. And so they didn't want to see all this coming back in their face, everything they had done. And so it says in verse 18, they had called them in. They commanded them not to speak at all nor teach in the name of Jesus. But Peter and John answered and said unto them, "Whether it be right in the sight of God to hearken unto you more than unto God, judge you. For we cannot but speak the things which we have seen and heard." Now, if you're a child of God, you've been born again. You have met Jesus Christ. You have been saved. And that's the most important information that you can give anybody at any time. We try to be politically correct as Christians, we're going to fail God. God is not politically correct. God's not on a side. God is the side. We need to understand that we serve a living and true God. And he says that we are led by his Spirit. Those that are led by his Spirit are the sons of God, whereby we cry, "Abba, Father," which means he's our daddy. And he loves us with an everlasting love. And what he wants us to do is put our faith and trust in him in these troubled times. When we have the news media saying that the Catholic Church or the Pope is turning to join the Bible with evolution, so to speak. You've got CEOs coming up and at major corporations and saying a gift from God is the greatest gift I've ever been given is being gay. We know that's blasphemous. God has never given anybody the gift of sin. God gives us the gift of salvation to put down sin. And so I encourage you, child of God, today, tomorrow morning when you're in church, don't just sit in church because it's Sunday and you feel like you need to be there. You go there to give God praise and glory and worship. And when you're out on the street, you proclaim Jesus Christ as Peter and John did. I want to read something to you right before we end this. What happens when you die to self and quit worrying about what people think or what people are going to say and just focus on Christ? They prayed a prayer that shook that entire church they were in. When they were released from these men, they went back to their church and they went to pray. And toward the end of the prayer, it says, "And now, Lord, behold their threatenings," talking about the guys that persecuted them, "and grant unto thy servants that with all boldness they may speak thy word, by stretching forth thine hand to heal, and the signs and wonders may be done by the name of the Holy Child Jesus." And when they had prayed, the place was shaken where they were assembled together, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and they spake the word of God with boldness. What would happen if tomorrow we all went to church and we prayed, "God, you hear the threatenings. You hear us telling us not to pray in Jesus' name. You hear us the telling us that we can't proclaim God's truth because some people would look at it as hate speech when it's the word of God. It's not even our opinion. It's God's word." What would happen if we prayed, "God, don't protect us. Don't help us be politically correct. But God, embolden us to be powerful and go back and even proclaim your son Jesus in a greater way." Until next time, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our heart be acceptable in his sight. O Lord, our strength and our redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen.